healthy crops using a whole lot less water. In tonight's Fox 40 Focus report, Dennis Shanahan takes us inside a 3-acre greenhouse in Davis for an up-close look at what could be the future of farming.
Tens of thousands of cars drive past it every day. You can't miss it along Interstate 80 in Davis. A massive greenhouse made of glass and steel with a prominent sign reading Gotham Greens. Fox 40 reached out to the company looking to learn more about what's going on inside.
Well, it's great to have you here today.
Viraj Puri is the co-founder and CEO of Gotham Greens. His roots are in New York. That's where the company's first greenhouse was built about 10 years ago to bring fresh greens to the Big Apple.
And we actually operate a whole network of these facilities across the U.S.
The Davis greenhouse, constructed last year, is the company's first on the West Coast and one of its largest, covering 3 acres.
Yet we're producing the crop yields of over 100 acres.
Instead of soil, the roots of each plant are anchored in a small pot of peat moss, and they are planted in trays of nutrient-rich water. The technical term for this kind of farming is hydroponics. Compared to conventional outdoor lettuce growing, Puri says this method uses 95% less water.
We capture all the irrigation water for reuse, so we're able to grow a full head of lettuce using approximately 2 or 3 gallons of water, while it can take up to 40 gallons of water to grow that same head of lettuce out in the field.
There are limits to what the company will allow news cameras to capture inside the facility. A lot of proprietary technology is at work here in what is quickly becoming a competitive industry.
We've got sensors that help track all the conditions, the light, the humidity, the CO2, the oxygen, all these different variables that a plant needs to grow. And then our computer control systems will help turn equipment on and off to achieve those conditions.
There are no changing seasons in a Gotham Greens facility. It's always growing season.
So we utilize natural sunlight to provide the photosynthesis that the crops need to grow. But we've got air conditioning systems, we've got heating systems.
The greens are thriving and showing up on local grocery store shelves.
They're not having to deal with the hot weather, the cold weather, unseasonable rain or hail or wind. So they're very coddled plants, as we like to say. And a happy plant makes for a healthy plant.
The greenhouse is just a couple of miles away from the UC Davis campus, and through a partnership with the university, it serves as a kind of 3-acre classroom for students studying the future of farming.
We're training, if you like, the next generation of farmers who will be going to companies like Gotham Greens.
Dr. Gail Taylor is a distinguished professor and chair of the Plant Sciences Department at UC Davis. She says the university is also helping educate Gotham Greens employees.
Things like shelf life, ensuring the best quality produce, and the conditions that the company might be using to ensure that.
Taylor points out UC Davis pioneered methods of farming that don't require soil 100 years ago. The difference in recent years is the technology that has made hydroponic farming profitable and feasible on a large scale.
We can grow these crops more cheaply. We can recycle water so that they have a place in the food supply chain. So one of the keys is getting that special recipe of nutrients that the plants require absolutely spot on. And with many companies, that's their big secret.
Taylor says don't expect greenhouses to ever entirely replace outdoor farming. After all, the average person in America eats about 12 pounds of lettuce a year.
So we really rely on sustainable production systems outdoors too. 85 to 95% of all of the lettuce in the US is grown in California. So it's a really important production system. And even in the outdoor systems, we're learning how to do it much more effectively.
But these indoor farms can be game changers, growing clean, pesticide-free, nutritious foods in urban areas and food deserts, places where crops don't easily grow outdoors.
Think of those food miles, trucking and flying food around the country, around the world. That's not great for the environment. So suddenly with these indoor systems, we can place them where people need food. So we also cut down on food miles, which has a greenhouse gas cost. So it's another way we can improve the environment.
And lettuce is just the tip of the iceberg.
Us plant scientists, we suddenly have the power to reimagine plants, all sorts of foods. Be it leafy greens or strawberries or tomatoes.
So I think it's really incumbent on us, farmers, entrepreneurs, technologists, policymakers, and academics, to really innovate and come up with new forms of farming that use less water.
Farms of the future, taking root today. In Davis, Dennis Shanahan, Fox 40 News.